Raymond Tan seems to be doing a penance of some sort. He is carrying a spiritual kavadi up a steep hill, and he may never make it to the top. That steep hill is a battle for the rights of the native people of Peninsular Malaya, rights seemingly alienated to them by the British colonial government in various documents, titles and minutes of meetings. It is a tragedy that the original inhabitants of this land have no rights to it, regardless of what government rules.
Let's look at your role. What is your role here?
My role is basically to help those that is incapable of helping themselves.
But why are you doing it? Why are you taking this battle on for the Orang Asli?
Because there's nobody else to do this.
But isn't it a losing battle, Raymond? I mean, whether it's the Barisan government or now it seems even the Pakatan government, you know,
they
see that this issue of rights over land and all that is very much in the gray zone. Okay, so because the Temuans are maybe not so educated, they are very simple people. You know that they've been bullied throughout these years, whether it's BN government or Pakatan government. Okay, they've been bullied and they continue to be bullied. Okay, and you have to take their issues all the way maybe to the courts and whatnot, right? What are you hoping to get? Are you getting paid for this?
When I first started this about 2.5 years ago, I was advised and was told by many not to get involved because you will never win, you cannot win over the countries or the policy that was created by the modern people. It's definitely an uphill battle, and whether we're going to win or not, we let God decide. So what future can bring, what's the outcome of it now. How difficult is this battle? Basically, everyone, common sense will tell you, you are not going to win this. You are challenging basically whatever that was created by law, written law, by the modern people. And not we talk about challenging the government, whether it's Pakatan, Barisan or whatnot. It's up to them to decide. We can only, or I can only guide them to a path that they have some percentage of winning. Maybe not all the overall issue on Asli, but at least there's a hope that they might have certain rights and certain say over certain area.
So you still think it's a winnable battle?
To me, I do not know how to lose, because we are fighting the noble war, which is the right thing. You can't just take away human rights.
Then who's paying you?
Nobody is paying me.
So how are you surviving with all this? Are you an NGO?
I'm not an NGO, I'm not.
Why is it that you don't want to establish a Mukim Tanjung 12 NGO, for example? So you can fight for this, and then you have an organization, and NGOs normally are easier to get funding than an individual.
We tried getting, asking for help, I mean fundings and all. Many people, and all of them will not help, because nobody believe that this thing can be won. It's more like a charity for them if they want to ever help or pump up some money for this Asli, you know, to help fund this case. But up to date, that is one of the reasons why it took me 2.5 years to get to where I am, or where we are,
which is where
almost ground zero. Whether we get the funding or not, the losing
you're doing a penance. In a way, you know, it's like you're carrying kabaddi, but the kabaddi is not a physical kabaddi, but it's a personal spiritual kabaddi for you.
Yep. Just try to do something noble.
The problem is why you fighting is losing, but the orang asli make a very small portion of the electorate. Basically, that's it. And nobody cares a damn because of that. Their votes don't count. Right? At the end of it.
Winky, winky.